a sad young lad, and a childless baker.
More than I
with his wife.
More than any. More than others.
I wish he's living the festival.
More than
I wish.
I wish to go to the festival.
More than riches.
I wish my cow would give us a milk.
More than any.
I wish we had a dog.
I want a dog.
Please, mom.
I wish to go to the festival.
I wish you'd give us a milk.
Had died.
You, Cinderella, the festival! You should go to the festival! The king's festival!
And her father had taken for his new wife
the festival.
A woman with two daughters of her own.
Look at your dance, look at your dress. Nevertheless, I still wish to go to the festival and dance before the prince!
Jack, on the other hand, had no father, and his mother,
I wish,
well, she was not quite beautiful.
My son were not a fool. I wish the house was not a mess. I wish the cow was full of milk. I wish the walls were full of gold. I wish a lot of things. You foolish child, what in heaven's name are you doing with a cow inside the house?
The fire, they might be justified. You know, I asked to produce his milk.
She! How many times must I tell you, only she's can produce milk?
Surprise for her.
I have emptied some lentils into the ashes for you. If you have them picked out again in 2 hours' time, you shall go to the ball with us.
And perhaps I'll sit game.
Listen, son, milk your wife must be taken to market.
Oh, he's the best cow.
What?
father in a baking accident. Well, at least that's what he believed anyway. He was eager to have a family of his own, and was very concerned that all efforts until now had previously failed.
Who could that be?
We have no more bread.
It's the witch from next door.
We have no bread.
Unless you have no bread.
But what do you wish?
It's not what I wish. It's what you wish. Nothing cooking in there now, is
there? The old enchantress went on to tell the couple that she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought you and his young wife to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother was a child, and she had developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father that what he wanted more than anything in the world was greens, greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, capers, and celery, asparagus, and put up on the monocrats, and lettuce. He said, all right, but it wasn't quite. Because I caught him in the yard of my garden one day. He was loving me, chasing me, waiting to run his labor, and then I was going to take everything up my family and my family and my family. And I said, I'm not going to mess there! I'm going to turn him into stone! For a dog, for a chair, for a...
But the witch refused to tell him any more about his sister. Not even that her name was Rapunzel. She went on.
I thought it had been well and reasonable, and that we could all go on living happily thereafter. But I would like to know what your father had hidden in his pocket. You see, my mother had warned me when I inherited that garden that I would be punished if I were to ever lose any of the beans.
Beans? The festival!
Look what I found in Paula's hunting jacket.
Six beans.
You don't think they're...
Witches' beans will take them with us.
No, you're not to come.
I know you're fearful of the woods at night.
No, the spell is on my house. Only I can lift the spell.
No, no, the spell is on our house. For we must lift the spell together.
We're not coming, that is fine. Now what am I to return with?
As for Cinderella,
I still wish to go to the festival. But how am I ever to get to the festival? I know I'll face in my disgrace, the grave and the fist. And tomorrow I just want to go to the king's festival. Into the woods it's time to go, and maybe all in vain I know. Into the woods believe, and so I must to take the journey. Into the woods the path is straight, I know it well, but who can tell?
Thank you.
hello, girl. What's your rush? You're missing all the flowers. The sun won't set for hours. Take your time. The slow little girl, hark and hush. The birds are singing sweetly. You'll miss the birds completely. You're traveling so fleetly. Grandmother first. Something fresh on the palate. Think of that scrumptious cardinality twice in one day. There's no possible way to describe what you feel when you're talking to your meal.
What was harm to come to that little girl in the red cape?
But that little girl is something!
Oh, you frightened me!
That's the prince! Get it! Get it!
How am I supposed to get it?
You go up to the little girl and you take it!
I can't just take a cape from a little girl. Why don't you take it?
If I could, I would. But I can't!
Ridiculous! I'll never get that red cape, or a golden cow, or a yellow slipper. Or was it a yellow cow and a golden slipper?
The cow was white as milk, the cape was red as blood, the hair as yellow as corn, the
slipper. What are you doing here?
You forgot your scarf.
No! You have no business being alone in the woods. You have no idea what I have happened upon. You would be frightened for your life. Now go home.
Oh, but I wish to help.
No, the spell is on my house. Only I can lift the spell.
No, no, the spell is on our house.
No.
We must lift the spell together. The spell is on
home.
The cow is white as...
A good day there, young lad.
Hello, sir.
What might you be doing with a cow in the middle of the forest?
I was on my way to market, but seem to have lost my way.
Oh.
And what are you planning to do?
And what are you planning to do there?
Oh, sell my cow, sir. No less than 5 pounds.
5 pounds? What am I to get 5 pounds?
5 pounds. She must be generous of milk to fetch 5 pounds.
Yes, ma'am.
And if you can't fetch that sum, then what are you to do?
I hadn't thought of that. I suppose my mother and I will have no food to eat.
This is the sum total.
Beans! We mustn't give up our precious beans. Oh, but if you feel we must, beans will bring you food, son.
Beans in exchange for my cow?
Oh, but these are no ordinary beans. These beans carry magic.
Magic? What kind of magic?
Tell him.
Magic that defies description.
Oh, I don't know.
You'd be lucky to exchange her for a sack of beans.
How many beans?
6.
5! We can't part with all of them. Besides, I'd say they're worth a pound each at the very least.
Can I have my cow back someday?
Possibly. Thank you, and good day to you.
I hate to
Quickly, take the cow and go home.
I was trying to be helpful.
Magic beings. We've no reason to believe they're magic, but we should dispel this curse through deceit.
No one would have given him more for this creature. At least now they'll have some food.
Five beans.
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you get it.
Home.
Do we want a child or not? Or you give and you take and you bid and you bargain and you live to regret it.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs and in betweens. No one waits when fortune intervenes. And maybe they're really magic, who knows? Why you do what you do, that's the point. All the rest of it is chatter.
Because she's crying.
If the thing you do is pure in intent and it's meant and it's just a little bent, does it matter?
Yes.
No, what matters is that everyone tells tiny lies. What's important really is the size. Only three more tries, we'll have a prize. When the end is sight, you'll realize. If the end is right, it justifies the beans.
Take the cow and go home. I will carry this out in my own fashion.
And so the baker continued his search for the cape as red as blood. As for Rapunzel, the witch was careful not to lose this beauty to the outside world, and so locked her up in a tower that lay deep within the forest. And when the old enchantress wished to call forth to her, she would call...
Grandmother has a mighty snore. Odd. Where is the little one? Eating, no doubt. Or eaten! Grandmotherhood! What is that red cloth? What that red cloth in the corner of your mouth? It appears to be a... I will get the cloth from within your stomach.
They say that he's charming.
We did nothing but dance.
Yes,
slippers.
I must get home.
As pure as gold. Hey, wait, I need your shoe. Oh, hey, come back here.
Five gold pieces! this, I could buy baking supplies for years. I could buy a new thatch roof, a new chimney.
But could you buy yourself a child?
Who are you?
When first I appeared, I seemed delirious, but when explained, I'm nothing serious. Could you buy yourself a child?
I don't understand.
How much do you want a child for? 5 gold pieces? 10? 20?
I never thought of those.
Exactly! You've not thought about a lot of things, have you, son?
Give me the money, it's not yours!
Nor is it Jack's. The money is not what's important. What's important is that your wish be honored.
Ha! I want the money! Come back here! What are you doing here?
I see you've the red cape.
Yes! Yes, I've only 2 items left to locate.
3.
2 are the cow and the cape.
Reuse the cape!
What have you done with the cow?
She ran away. I've never reached home. I've been looking for her all night.
I should have never entrusted her to you.
She might as just have easily run from you.
But she did.
But she might
but
have.
But she did.
Who cares? The cow is gone! Get it back! Get it.
We were just going to do that. Look, I can give you this.
Don't give me that! I don't want to test that before. Have you no sense? Deliver the items by tomorrow's midnight, or you wish you never thought to have a child. Pow! Oh! Pow!
I hate that woman.
I'm sorry I lost the cow.
It's okay, I shouldn't have yelled. Now go back home. I will make this right. And then we can just go back to living our lives. No more hunting in the woods for strange objects. No more witches, or dim-witted boys, or hungry little girls. Go.
Good brother. Father and I have wondered where you've gone.
I've been looking all night for her.
Her?
The beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Where did she go?
Disappeared, like a fine morning mist.
She was lovely?
The loveliest.
I'm not certain of that, though I must confess I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives here, in the wood.
The wood?
Yes, at the top of a tall tower that has no stairs or door.
Where?
2 leagues from here, due east, beyond Monte.
And how do you manage a visit?
Well, I stand beneath her tower, and I say, Rapunzel!
Rapunzel!
Let down your hair to me, and she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel! What kind of a name is that? You jest! I've never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth! She's as true as your maiden, a maiden running from a prince. None would run from us.
Yet one has.
Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony, beyond power of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in a tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her head.
Thank you. just out of reach. Agony that can cut like a knife. I must have her to
partial to a white cow.
That's one.
Have you seen the cow?
Yes. I don't get whoever again. Children can be very cruel. You be careful with your boat.
I don't have any children.
That's okay.
Yes, well, I've not seen your son today. I'm sorry.
I hope you didn't go back up that beanstalk again. Quit while you're ahead, I say. Jack! Jack! Jack?
Moo! Moo!
Now, now, looking for your pal!
Where did you find her?
Are you?
stay back home with our beautiful prize. Just a few of us, it takes trust. It takes just a bit more and we're done. We want four, we have nine, we got three. We need one, it takes two.
Stop her! Stop that hen!
Oh, oh my!
Providence, my Milky White, and the owners, and my head.
Oh, look what this hen has laid in my head.
A golden egg. I've never seen a golden egg.
You see, sir, I promise you more than the 5 gold pieces I gave you.
5 gold pieces?
I did not say that I would sell.
But you took the 5 gold pieces.
Well, you took 5 gold pieces.
I did not take, you gave.
Where are the 5 gold pieces?
Well, you see, this old man.
You said I could have my cow back.
I did not say could, I said might.
Milky White is dead!
True!
To a live one.
You must go back to the village in search of another cow.
And what do you propose I use to buy this cow?
Here. Tell them it's magic.
No one with a brain larger than this would exchange a cow for a bean.
Then steal it.
Steal it? Just 2 days ago you were accusing me of exercising deceit in securing the cow.
Then don't steal it and resign yourself to a childless life.
Feel it best you go for the cow, as I have encountered a maid in these previous eves, and I think I might secure in stealing one of her shoes.
That's fine. That is just fine!
Unfortunately for Rapunzel, the witch discovered of her affections for the prince before he could spirit her away.
What did I clearly say? Children should listen!
No, no, please!
What have you got to do? Children must see! What have I been to you? What would you have me be? Have some life of bread.
Thank you.
had a visitor. I will not share you, but I will show you a world you have never seen before.
What a beautiful cape!
Stay away from my cape, or I slice you into a thousand pieces.
I don't want it. I was just admiring it.
My granny made it for me from a wolf that attacked us, and I got to skin the animal invisible. She gave this beautiful nine gold protection.
Well, I have a golden hen that lays golden eggs. From the kingdom of the giants, up there. And if you think that's something, you should see the golden heart the giant has. It plays the most beautiful tunes without you having to touch it.
Girls, is that? Why don't you go up to the kingdom right now and bring him back and show me?
I could.
You could not.
I could.
You could not, Mr. Liar.
I'm not a liar. I'll get that part. I'll show you.
After having cast out Rapunzel to a remote desert, the witch returned to take the prince by surprise.
You wish to fetch your sweetheart, but the bird no longer lives in our cave.
And unfortunately for the prince, he fell into a patch of thorns which pierced his eyes and blinded him. As for Cinderella, she returned home from her final visit to the festival.
No, don't do that. I've already given up one shoe this evening. My feet cannot bear to give up another.
I need that shoe to have a child.
That doesn't make any sense.
Does it make any sense that you're running from a prince? Here, take my shoes. You'll run faster.
Who is that woman?
Who?
Lying will cost you your life.
I've done nothing.
I'm the cow.
The slipper. We both four. No.
I will take this and give it to the prince, and tomorrow we will search the kingdom for the maiden who will fit this shoe.
Please give it back to me. I really don't care if it costs me my life. Please.
Give me the slipper and all will come.
What was that noise?
Oh, just a bolt of lightning in the barbecue.
How dare you go off and search without me?
My apologies, sir. I thought that I might.
Oh, he doesn't want to talk. I employed a ruse and had the entire staircase smeared with pitch. And there, when she ran down, remained
the maiden's
slipper.
Brilliant.
I thought so. It did create quite a mess when the other guests left.
And, sir, I have succeeded in obtaining the...
Give her the slipper and all will come to a happy end!
Who are you, old man?
When first I appear, I seem deleterious, but
when... Shut up! Oh, do as he says. He's obviously a spirit of some sort, and we only need one.
Into the cup!
Now I'm pleased.
his father, and he and his wife, bewildered, returned home. The witch, who had been punished with age and ugliness, that night when his beans had been stolen and the lightning flashed, was now returned to his former state of youth and beauty. And Milky White, after a night of severe indigestion, was reunited with the now wealthy Jack. Until the day her prince, wandering aimlessly, heard a voice so familiar that he went towards it. And when he approached, Rapunzel, overjoyed at seeing him, fell into his arms, weeping. Two of her tears wetted his eyes, and their touch restored his vision.
Aha! I was going to confess you just as soon as you learned your lesson. This is who I truly am. Come with me, child. We can be happy as we once were.
She will not go with
you. Let her speak for herself.
Okay.
Delzo. You're the only family I've ever known. Come with me.
You leave me no choice.
In exchange for his youth and beauty, the witch lost his power over others. When the wedding with the prince was celebrated, Florinda and Lucinda attended, wishing to win favor with Cinderella and share in her good fortune. But as the sisters stood by the blessed couple, pigeons swooped down upon them and poked out their eyes and punished them with flies.
I see your prince has found you.
Yes.
Thank you for the slipper.
And it came to pass that all that seemed wrong was now right. The kingdoms were filled with joy, and those who deserved to were certain to live a long and happy life. Ever after.
Ever after.
Journey over, all is mended, and it's not just for today, but tomorrow, and extended, ever after,
ever after.
All the curses have been ended, the reverse is wiped away, all the tenderness and laughter, for forever.
Thank you.
once upon a time. Later, in the same far-off kingdom, lived a young princess, the lad Jack,
fish,
and the maker with his family. And he was first greeted by the princess. The story unfolds.
Excuse me.
Excuse me, madam, this small man with something.
Princess, I'm here to tell about a giant in the land.
Where did you see a giant?
Well, I didn't actually see it.
Then how do you know that there's a giant in the land?
Our home was destroyed, and there are footprints.
That could have been caused by any number of things. I'll show you the door.
Oh, no, a nearby household was visited by a giant not long ago descending from a beanstalk.
Yes, I remember.
Yeah, that giant was slain. Let's go.
Please, Princess, we have a small child. My child was very hard to come by. His safety is of great importance to me.
Are we entirely through now?
Yes.
I will take his music and the prince when he returns.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm going off to market, Jack.
Goodbye, Mother.
Now I want you to stay inside.
Well, Mother, I haven't been outside all day.
Look, Jack, I don't want you out when there might be giants on the loose.
But Mother, I know how to kill a giant.
Enough! We've had our fill of giants!
Oh, but Mother, if I could help in any way...
Please! I want you to stay in your surroundings.
But Mother, I'm a man now.
You're still a little boy in your mother's eyes. I want you to promise. Promise?
I promise.
What are we gonna do? This house is such a mess.
If I patch it here, I'll make it a bucket.
A bucket?
Wow, what's happened to your house?
We had a baking accident.
A baking accident?
No, you frightened the young thing.
You can't frighten her.
Well, I just frightened the bed. Besides, I have all that to carry.
Why such a load?
I'm living here with Granny.
Brother, how good to see you.
What brings you into the wood today?
I am investigating news of a giant.
You investigating news of a giant?
Father would not even do that. That's the business of your steward, or less.
Well, what brings you into the wood?
Well, Rapunzel has run off.
Run off?
Yes, she's a changed woman. She's been subject to hysterical fits of crying, moons, and no soul can predict. I know not what to do.
What a pity.
And Cinderella?
That she remains well.
Does she? Come now, brother, do tell what you're really doing here.
High in a tower, like yours was, but higher, a beauty asleep. All round the tower, thicket of briar, 100 feet deep. Vanity, no frustration more keen. When the one thing you want is a thing that you've not even seen.
I found a casket entirely of glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside the casket, a maiden, alas, just as unbreakable.
What unmistakable agony is the way always barred.
She has skin white as snow.
Did you learn her name?
No, there's a dwarf standing guard.
Always enthralled most to anything almost, or something asleep. If it were not for the thicket,
a thicket's no trick, is it thick?
It's the thickest,
the quickest is picking a part with a stick.
I guess, but even one prick, it's my thing about blood.
Well, it's sick.
It's no sicker than your thing with dwarves.
Dwarves are very upsetting.
Not forgetting the tasks unachievable, mountains unscalable, if it's conceivable, but unavailable. Agony, misery, not to know what you miss.
While they lie there for years and just cry on their fears,
what unbearable bliss.
Agony that can cut like a knife.
Well, back to my wife.
It's Rapunzel. I must be off. Godspeed to you, brother.
Godspeed.
We went down the dell.
Perhaps you forgot the way.
This is a stream.
Was straight. Now there is no path.
Where's the stream? Where's the lily pond? Where's Granny?
Calm down. I think we should turn back.
No.
We will just have to find Granny's house without the path.
But Mother warned me never to stray from the path.
The path has strayed from you.
Wait. That looks familiar. See, in the distance, three oak trees.
Oh, yes, I recognize.
Who might that be?
Oh, it's the royal family. Oh, what brings you into the woods?
Castle. I've been sent down by a giant.
Oh, no. I warned you. Why didn't you do something?
I don't think the policy I should have carried out.
And I warned you not to trust the royal family to solve your problem.
We should head back to the village.
Wouldn't be in such a hurry if I were you. Guess which path the giant took to the castle.
Oh.
All that was left of my garden was a sack of beans. And there's nothing left of your house, I think.
But I was told giants don't strike the same house twice.
Destroyed our house. Not a great win is because of you and no mother!
And who destroyed my house? That boy asked for shelter, and then he stole our gold, our hen, and our harp. Then he killed my husband. I must avenge the wrongdoings.
We are not responsible for him.
You're wasting your breath.
She's right. You can't reason with the dumb.
Not all giants are dumb. Give me the boy.
We told you he is not here.
Girls, tell me the truth.
I know he's there. And I'm going to wait right here until he's delivered to me.
The giant who was nearsighted remained convinced that he had found the lad. There was no general consensus among them as to which course of action to take.
Put a spell on her.
I no longer have my powers. If I did, do you think I'd be standing here with all of you? Now I'll have to give her someone.
Who?
The steward is in his line of duty to sacrifice his life.
Don't be ridiculous. I'm not giving up my life for anyone.
I'm waiting.
You must understand, these were people not familiar with making choices. Their past experiences in the woods had in no way prepared them for a force this great.
Excuse me. Would you like a little blind girl instead?
How dare you!
Put them out of their misery.
They were not that miserable!
What are you talking about?
She doesn't want a woman.
Fine, then what do you suggest we do?
I'm still waiting.
It is really interesting to examine the moral issues in question here. The finality of issues such as these dictates that... No, sorry, I tell the story, I'm not part of it.
Not one of us.
You're always on the outside.
But that's my role. You must understand there must always be someone on the outside.
You're on the inside now.
Yeah!
You are making a big mistake! There must always be an objective observer to pass the story along.
Some of us don't like the way that you've been telling them.
If you drag me into this mess, you will all be lost and you'll never know how the story ends.
Wait! He's the only one that knows the story.
Do you think it will be fun when you have to tell it yourself? And you, think of your baby.
Wait, he's right. Let him go. Put that away.
Oh, now that's better. You don't want to live in a world of chaos. There must always be...
Here's the lad!
No, the lad!
This is not the one!
Wait, don't go...
Why did you push her into his arms?
You wanted to get rid of him too.
We might have thought of something else.
If it was up to you, a decision would never be made. Never.
Now he's gone. We never know what will next happen next.
We manage.
Must I search among you for the lad?
No! Jack is just a boy and we had no food to eat. He had to sell his beloved cow in exchange for some magic bean. If anyone is to be punished,
he was your responsibility. Now I must punish him for his wrongs.
We've suffered too. Do you think it was a picnic disposing of your husband's remains?
You are getting me angry.
What about our anger? What about our loss? Who's been flouncing through our kingdom?
Shh, quiet.
I'll hide my son, and you'll never find him.
Don't upset the giant.
You'll never find him.
I'm warning you.
And if you don't go back this instant, we'll get you.
Where is your son? Is that him?
No! This is not the lad!
The boy is hiding in the steeple tower!
That's true! It's true!
If he is not, I will return and find you!
She's in poor condition.
Oh, please wake up.
Promise me you won't let them get to my son.
We won't.
As I stand here, Dexter, promise me.
I'll do what I can.
Promise.
I promise.
No. Come away from there. You killed her.
I was just thinking of the greater good. That's my job.
This is the world I meant.
Couldn't you listen? Couldn't you stay content, safe behind walls, as I could now?
Baby with her?
Yes, the baby's asleep. He'll be fine with the girl.
But what if the giant was to return here?
The giant will not harm them, I know.
How do you know?
I know.
But what if the giant was...
But what if? Will only a giant's foot stop your arguing? 100 paces. Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Roam alone in the woods?
No, actually, it was my choice. I'm looking for the lad.
Your choice? How brave.
Brave?
Yes. Anything can happen in the woods. May I kiss you? Any moment we could be crushed. Don't feel rushed.
A princess.
Oh, well, yes, I do.
And I have a baker.
Of course, you're right. Now, foolish. Foolishness can happen in the woods. Once again, please, let your hesitations be hushed. Any moment, big or small, is a moment after all. Seize the moment, skies may fall. Any moment. Blushed. Life is often and so unpleasant. You must know that as a peasant, best to take the moment present as a present for the moment.
May I be of some assistance?
The tree has fallen. Mother's grave is destroyed.
Oh, no.
My wishes have just been crushed.
Oh, don't say that.
It's true. You wouldn't understand.
Well, you can't say, here, there's a giant on the loose.
Search of the prince will see to it that the giant is freed from our land.
There's been no sign of the prince. No doubt he's off seducing some young maiden.
What?
I understand that's what princes do.
Well, not all princes.
You look just like the princess. Only dirty. You are the princess!
Please, get up. Get up!
What are you to do?
I must be on my way back to the castle.
Well, you haven't heard. We came upon the royal family. The castle has been set upon by the giant.
And the prince?
He was not with them. Come with me. You will be safe in our company.
I must leave you.
Why?
The giant.
Oh yes, the giant. I had almost forgotten. Will we meet each other in the woods again?
This was just a moment in the woods. Our moment shimmering and lovely and sad. Leave the moment, just be glad for the moment that we had. Every moment is a moment when you're in the woods. Now I must go off to slay the giant. That is what the next moment holds for me. I shall not forget you. How brave you are to be alone in the woods. And how alive you've made me feel.
What was that? Child, back to husband, you can't live in the woods. There are vows, there are ties, there are needs, there are standards, there are shouldn'ts and shoulds. Why not both instead? There's the answer if you're clever. Have a child more warmth than a baker for bread, and a prince for whatever. Never, it's these woods. Facts, find the boy, join the group, stop the giant, just get out of these woods. Was that me? No, it wasn't. Was that him? No, it wasn't. Just a trick of the woods. Just a moment. One peculiar passing moment. Must it all be either less or more, either plain or grand? Is it always or is it never end? That's what woods are for these moments in the woods. Oh, if life were made of moments, every now and then a better one. But if life were only moments, then you'd never known you had one. First a witch, then a child, then a prince, then a moment who can live in the woods. And to get what you wish, only just for these are dangerous wounds. Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment, no. Just remembering you've had an and when you're back to or makes the or mean more than it did before. Now I understand that it's time to leave the wood.
Thank you.
should be back by now.
She wouldn't get lost.
I'm sure that she'll return.
No. I must go in search of her.
May come too.
No. You stay here. I will count 100 paces. I shall return.
Look who I found.
Please don't let her get me to the giant.
It's not our fault the giant wants you.
Where did you find this? Where is my wife?
She's dead.
What?
I'm sorry, sir. I came upon her. She was under a tree.
He was crying over her like she was his own mother.
How could this happen? I should have never let her wander off alone.
This is no time for remorse.
My wife is dead!
Wake up! People are dying all around you. You are not the only one to suffer a loss. And you're dead. Now to get this boy to the giant before we're all so much dead
meat.
This is no time to be soft-hearted. This boy is going to the giant and I'm going to take him.
Yes! It's your fault! It's because of you that the giant in our midst and my wife is dead!
But it isn't my fault. I was given those beans. You persuaded me to trade away my cow for beans. And without those beans, there have been no stock to meet up to the giants in the first place.
Wait a minute, magic beans for cows so bold that you had to tell a lie to sell it, which you told. Where they were with beans, where they were sold. Oh, and tell us who persuaded you to steal that gold.
It's your fault.
No.
It's your fault.
No.
Yes, it is.
It's true.
But I only stole gold to get my cow back from you.
It's your fault.
No, it isn't. I just kept those beans, but our house was cursed. She made us get a cow and the curse reversed.
It's your father's fault.
I gave it to my wife. No, it isn't.
Then whose is it?
Wait a minute. She shaped that bean to obtain your shoes. So the one who knows what happened to the bean is you.
You mean that old bean that your wife owed here, but I never knew it, so I thought, well, don't look here.
It's your fault.
What?
It's her fault.
What?
And it isn't mine at all.
But what?
Well, if you had thought that got big again, you were greedy because you need that hen.
But I got it from my mother.
It's your fault, Dad.
Yes, and what about the harp in the third place?
The harp, yes.
She wouldn't dare me to.
I dare
to. You dare me to. She said that I was scared to. She dared me.
No, so it's your fault. Wait a minute. You had a dare to.
Here!
Maybe I shouldn't have stolen from the giant.
Maybe I shouldn't have strayed from the path.
Maybe I shouldn't have attended the ball.
Yes. Maybe you shouldn't.
Where are you going?
Away from here.
But you said we had to find our way out of this together.
It doesn't matter if we're together or we're apart.
But we need your help.
You don't understand! My wife was the one who really helped. I depended on her for everything.
He would leave your child?
I think my child would be happy in the arms of a princess.
But wait!
I thought you were dead.
Not completely. Are we ever?
As far as I'm concerned, you are.
Is that true?
Because of you, all of this has happened.
I strayed into the garden that night to get your mother a gift. And I foolishly took some of those beans for myself. How are we to know? How are we ever to know? When she died, I ran away from my guilt, and now aren't you doing the same thing?
No.
Aren't you running away?
No more questions. Please. No more tests. Comes the day we say what for. Please. No more.
They disappoint, they disappear, the tide, they don't. What? They disappoint, in turn I fear, forget though they don't.
No more riddles. All the joys, all the lies. verses.
Only made me sad.
brother hears I've slain the giant.
Jack, your mother is dead.
Dead? Was she killed by the giant?
She was arguing with the giant, trying to protect you. And she was struck a deadly blow by the prince's steward.
No. Why would he do that?
He thought she was provoking the giant.
Can no one bring her back?
No one.
That steward will pay for this. After we slay the giant, I will slay him.
You will do nothing of the kind.
But what he did was wrong, right?
I guess so.
Then he must die.
No.
But he shouldn't have killed my mother. He should be punished.
He will be somehow.
How?
I don't know. Stop asking me questions I can't answer.
I'm gonna kill him.
Then kill him.
The birds.
no one to take care of me.
You'll have to take care of yourself now, Jack. It's time.
No, it's not. I take care of him.
You will?
Yes. I'll be your mother now.
I don't want another mother. I want a friend and a pet.
Father and mother, you'll know what to do.